Assalamu alaikum dear doctors, in this video I am discussing about constituents of infant's feet. This information I have taken from clinical cases for MRCPCH theory and science book, case number 45. So, whilst latex is a relatively common cause of allergy in later life, it is rarely seen as a trigger in early infancy. Most infant treats are in fact made of silicone, although specialist latex treats are available. A basic understanding of the constituents of an infant feet is important for pediatricians. First, proteins. Whey and casein. Whey and casein are the main source of protein in human milk. Colostrum is mainly whey, and the ratio of whey to casein moves towards 50-50 later in lactation. First infant formula based on cow's milk have their whey casein ratio altered to around 60-40, in line with human milk early in lactation. Alpha-lactalbumin and beta-lactoglobulin are the main whey produces in human milk. Cow's milk has less alpha-lactalbumin than human milk, and some artificial formulas supplement this. So I am again repeating the protein portion of infant feed, that whey and casein are the main source of protein in human milk. Colostrum is mainly whey, and the ratio of whey to casein moves towards 50-50 later in lactation. First infant formula based on cow's milk have their whey casein ratio altered to around 60-40 in line with human milk early in lactation. Alpha lactalbumin and beta lactoglobulin are the main whey proteins in human milk. Cow's milk has less alpha lactalbumin than human milk, and some artificial formulas supplement this. Now, carbohydrate portion. Carbohydrate, the main carbohydrate in both human milk and cow's milk is lactose. Remember, carbohydrate is lactose. Lactose-free or reduced lactose milks may derive their carbohydrate from maize or protease or other sugar such as glucose, sucrose or corn syrup. I am again repeating carbohydrate portions. The main carbohydrate in both human milk and cow's milk is lactose. Lactose-free or reduced lactose milk may derive their carbohydrate from maize or protease or other sugar such as glucose, sucrose or corn syrups. Now, fat. Fat supplies up to 50% of the energy in breastfeed infant. The amount of fat in breast milk changes during the feed and during the lactation period. Infant formula normally contain fat from vegetable oil that supply around 50% of dietary energy. So I am again repeating fat portion. Fat supplies up to 50% of the energy in breastfeed infants. The amount of fat in breast milk changes during the feed and during the lactation period. Infant formula normally contain fat from vegetable oils that supply around 50% of dietary energy. Now, nucleotide. Nucleotide are synthesized from amino acid in the body to form DNA and RNA. Colostrum has a higher concentration of nucleotides, and this reduces over the first 4 weeks of lactation. All standard infant formulas are supplemented with nucleotides. So, nucleotides are synthesized from amino acid, remember, and in the body to form DNA and RNA. Colostrum has a higher concentration of nucleotides. So, colostrum has a higher concentration of nucleotides, and this reduces over the first 4 weeks of lactation. All standard infant formulas are supplemental with nucleotides. Now, long-chain polyunsaturated fatty acid, LCPS. These are found in small quantities in human milk and are found in high concentration in neutral tissues and the retina, whilst they can be synthesized in the body. Many infant formulas are now supplemented with LCPS, however, evidence of breast milk is lacking. I am again repeating long-chain polyunsaturated fatty acid, LCPS. These are found in small quantities in human milk. Remember, LCPS, long-chain polyunsaturated fatty acids, is found in small quantities in human milk and are found in high concentration in neutral tissue and the retina. Whilst they can be synthesized in the body, many infants' formula are now supplemented with LCPS, however, evidence of benefits is lacking. Now, vitamins and minerals. Vitamins and minerals are better absorbed from human milk than cow's milk formulas. As a result, higher concentrations are required in infant formula and are present in human milk. So, vitamins and minerals are better absorbed from human milk than from cow's milk formula. As a result, higher concentrations are required in infant formula than are present in human milk. So, we understand that protein mainly whey and casein, and carbohydrate mainly both human milk and cow's milk is, that is lactose. Please do subscribe and share Dr. Emma's Medicine YouTube channel. Thank you.